Well, a day after a setback for Sonia and Rahul Gandhi in an income tax case in the Delhi High Court, the BJP has upped the political ante today with Union Minister Smriti Irani holding a press conference to attack the Gandhi family. She said the Congress had been exposed with this case, while the Congress has accused the BJP of what they called petty revenge and denied any wrongdoing. The case relates to the IT department's move to reassess the returns of the Gandhis for the year 2011-12. The IT department says Rahul Gandhi did not disclose that he was the director of a company called Young India, a not-for-profit organization. Rahul and Sonia Gandhi are major stakeholders in Young Indian, which acquired Associated Journals Limited. The National Herald newspaper was published by Associated Journals Limited, and it was BJP MP Subramaniam Swamy who, in a private criminal complaint filed before a trial court, has accused Sonia and Rahul Gandhi and others of conspiring to cheat and misappropriate funds by paying just 50 lakhs, through which Young India had obtained the right to recover more than 90 crores, which the Associated Journal owed to the Congress party. The tax department says that the shares Rahul has in Young Indian would have led him to have an income of 154 crores that year and not just 68 lakhs, as was assessed earlier. The issue, though, has snowballed into a huge political row.
Delhi mein court ke madhyam se राहुल गांधी श्रीमती प्रियंका वाड्रा श्रीमती सोनिया गांधी सवालों के घेरे में आए. यंग इंडियन नाम की एक कंपनी जिसे स्थापित करते हैं श्री राहुल गांधी इस मंशा के साथ कि वो कोई प्रॉफिट और लॉस नहीं करेगी खरीदती है एसोसिएटेड जर्नल्स की एक नामक कंपनी को जिसका काम ही कमर्शियल है. क्यों एक कंपनी जिसका काम नहीं है प्रॉफिट या लॉस करना एक कमर्शियल कंपनी को खरीदती है? इस प्रश्न का उत्तर राहुल जी को देना चाहिए. ये प्रश्न मैं राहुल जी से कर रही हूं क्योंकि कंपनी राहुल जी की है, कांग्रेस पार्टी की नहीं है.
पीपल हु डू नॉट हैव ए ग्रेजुएशन डिग्री बिकॉज दे से देयर क्वालिफिकेशंस आर थ्री डिफरेंट क्वालिफिकेशंस शुड एट लीस्ट आस्क टेक सच ओपिनियन फ्रॉम वेरी लर्नड पीपल इन द बीजेपी बिफोर लेवलिंग प्रीपोस्टरस स्टूपिड एंड फूलिश एलिगेशंस. जब आप पॉलिटिकल रेलेवेंस खो लें जैसा स्मृति ईरानी जी ने खो दी है, क्योंकि उन्होंने कभी कोई चुनाव तो जीता नहीं जिंदगी में. बड़ी विनम्रता से मैं उन्हें हाथ जोड़कर कहता हूं, थोड़ी सी पढ़ लिख ले व्यक्ति तो कोई नुकसान नहीं हो जाता उसमें, अच्छा रहता है इस तरह के बेबुनियाद बचकाना और बगैर तथ्यों के इल्जाम लगाने के.
Joining us tonight, we have Dr. Abhishek Singhvi, who is, of course, a senior lawyer and senior spokesperson of the Congress Party. Mr. Chandrakumar Bose of the BJP is here in the studio with us. Rajiv Desai, public policy analyst, columnist and author Tavleen Singh, and senior journalist Aarti Jarath also with us today. Dr. Singhvi, to you first. How is it that the Congress does not see the High Court order as a setback and as petty revenge? Look, at the end of the day, the Income Tax Department says it wants to reassess the returns of Rahul and Sonia Gandhi for a particular year, and the court agrees that that should happen.
Well, obviously, by not accepting our plea, we have lost the High Court. If you talk of it in that way, you can call it a setback. Although, both we can appeal against it to Supreme Court, an option open to us. Second, we can go back to the IT Department to assess us in accordance with law, because this was a writ petition challenging the very reopening. But that's not the point, Nidhi. There is a legal aspect to it, there is a political aspect to it. I'll be very brief, but it's important for informed debate to understand that legal, factual and political aspect. National Herald is a Congress paper with the ideals of Congress, made by Nehru, had fallen on bad times, its debts had to be cleaned up. So all that happened was that the debt which National Herald Associated Journals Company owed to the Congress party, AICC, was transferred to a Section 25 company. In that Section 25 company, no doubt Rahul Gandhi and Sonia Gandhi were shareholders. Now, four points are very important. They don't get a single penny as salary, as remuneration, as anything. They are part of a 25 company, which by law means that it's a not-for-profit company. So you can't even wind it up. If you wind it up, it must go to another charitable kind of institution. It doesn't go to shareholders. The company can pay no dividend. In law, number three, a shareholder does not own any asset of the company. This was only done so that the balance sheet of National Herald AJL is cleaned up to revive it into a running company. For not earning a penny, remuneration, salary, benefit, the IT department, and mind you, this is very important. This relates to the assessment year ending on 31/3/12. The bar of time on this expires on 31/3/18. 6 years is the bar of time. Nidhi, can you imagine the vendetta? At 11:38 p.m. on 31/3/18, an email is sent by the IT department, as if I must sit up all night looking at emails of the IT department, saying we want to reopen at the proverbial 11th hour, 59th minute. Because after 12 o'clock, you can't reopen even. So this is what smacks of, you see, you have to divert attention from petrol prices, diesel prices, demonetization problems, Rozgar unemployment problems.
But can I just ask you one question, Dr. Singhvi? Did Rahul Gandhi declare that he was a director in Young Indian? Did Rahul Gandhi declare that he was a director in Young Indian? Because that's the heart of all of this. This is what the IT department says he didn't do.
The whole world, that's a very important question. For getting a directorship, it's an open process. You have to file returns in the ROC. Now, you may not declare in your IT return, but it's declared in the company's list of people. And if a person is not, just imagine, a 25 company cannot pay dividend, cannot pay salary, cannot pay remuneration. So what is there to hide? The IT department is saying what? Do you understand? That the value of the loan, which was written off when the loan was assigned to Young India, that value must be proportionately held to accrue to each shareholder of Young India. So 155 crores in the hands of Rahul Gandhi, 155 crores in the hand of Sonia Gandhi. I mean, this is bizarre.
No, so did he declare that he was a director that year? Did he declare his income?
That it sounds complicated in IT law.
So did he declare that he was a director?
It is declared in the returns of the company.
Okay. So, but
it is declared in the returns of the company. What is there to hide? This is a company which is listed.
The question then
is... The company is known. Mr. Swami, just one second. Mr. Swami made this complaint in 2004 or 2005. After 2014 also, the preponderance of view in the department was no cases made out.
Okay, so
11:38 in the night on 31st of March,
let me get to the rest of the panel on this.
A notice is sent 15 minutes before.
Okay, so Mr. Bose, would you say that it is rather odd that the IT department did send this 20 minutes before the deadline? Ideally, if there is a merit in this case, and there may still well be, should that notice not have come much earlier than 20 minutes before?
By email. The limitation? By email.
Well, I think that question the IT department should can only answer. But you see, what my grandfather Sarat Chandra Bose used to say, he was also a very senior Congress leader, what is morally wrong cannot be politically right. So I think we need to also examine this issue, whether it was morally right for the Congress to help out. You see, the National Herald is a separate entity. It was founded by Jawaharlal Nehru. It was his journalistic acumen which made him form this entity. But could party funds be used? It was bankrupt. Yeah, why the National Herald got bankrupt is a different matter. But don't you think it is morally wrong to use party funds in order to salvage the bankruptcy of a newspaper, National Herald? That is a question I would like to ask. You see, Mr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi is a brilliant lawyer. He can certainly put forward the legal aspect. But I think as politicians, what about our morals? Can we just manipulate accounts? Can we use funds, money laundering, embezzlement? These are questions that people of the nation would like to know from Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi.
Before I get Abhishek Singhvi to answer that, Rajiv Desai, would you come in on that about the moral question that the BJP is raising here today? I'm asking a bigger question. I'm asking whether for the next election campaign, this is going to be the focus, that the focus of Narendra Modi and the BJP is really going to be to target the Gandhi family and its track record on corruption or lack of dealing with corruption. Mr. Desai.
Well, it has historically been the sort of objective of the BJP and Modi-led BJP government to go after the Gandhis. But be that as it may, I'm impressed that Mr. Bose dropped names of his father and grandfather and his relationship to the Congress, and then spoke blithely about a moral issue. This, coming from a person, from a party, where Mr. Amit Shah's son multiplied his income within a few days into multiple crores, from a party that has not answered questions on Vyayam, from a party that is running away from arguing the Rafale deal. What right could they possibly have of talking about moral things? Mr. Modi runs away from questions. He's not stood up and answer any questions. Mr. Shah doesn't answer any questions about his son. They filed a defamation case against the wire and tried to intimidate them. So intimidation, lies, improbable moral posturing, these are all the dying gasps of a collapsing party that knows that its writ has been run. It's over for them, and so now they continue to do. Otherwise, how will they answer?
What about the substance of the case at hand?
Not one word, not one word uttered by anybody from the BJP is in my listing considered any word of substance at all. So I won't even argue the substance. I'm just talking about the motive. And Abhishek pointed to the motive. They have a motive. They have nothing left to go to the
election. Okay, so let me just get Tavleen Singh and Aarti Jarad for quick first comments before we go back to Dr. Singhvi. Tavleen, is this just political vendetta, as we hear? You know, every time a case is filed against any party, we hear the words political vendetta. How do you see this? I mean, is this something that is going to be raked up again and again ahead of the elections? And, you know, is this actually a serious political setback to the Congress?
Well, I don't know if it's a serious political setback, but it's not the BJP that filed this case. It was Subramaniam Swamy, and a little bit dodgy about the whole thing is, why was this young Indian set up with two close friends of the Gandhi family being the only other people on the board? You know, I mean, the Congress Party has behaved like a private limited company for a very long
time. My apologies. I think we've just lost that link to Tavleen there. Aarti Jarath, your take on this, your political take on this.
You know, Nidhi, I don't know about the merits and demerits of the case, okay? I mean, I think
that's really for
the court to decide, for the Income Tax Department to investigate and take a decision. But I do think it is very strange. Subramaniam Swamy has been screaming about this case for years. He went to court many years ago. It has taken the Income Tax Department all this time to actually reopen the case. And they reopen it just as elections are around the corner. So, you know, I mean, clearly, you know, the BJP intends to make political hay out of this. And, you know, as you saw in the National Executive meeting, the entire National Executive was focused on attacking the Gandhis, you know, and Rahul Gandhi and the Congress Party. There was nothing said on any burning issue of the day, you know, fuel prices, rural distress. They didn't even address those issues. They just went at the Gandhi family. And, you know, I find this obsession with the Gandhi family, the BJP's obsession with the Gandhi family, quite amusing, because, you know, in a way, they are really elevating Rahul to, you know, a sort of a contestant, a rival to Narendra Modi. Whereas Narendra Modi, according to them, is the most popular leader in India, and therefore it cannot be questioned, his popularity cannot be questioned. So why do they bring Rahul Gandhi into every sentence?
Mr. Bose, do you want to answer that? Is there a BJP obsession with the Gandhis?
First, I would like to address the issue. You see, prior to independence, everyone was with the Indian National Congress. My great uncle was the last elected president of the Congress, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose in 39. Now, coming to today's context, you see, Rahul Gandhi is the president of the Congress today. And Narendra Modi ji is the prime minister. He's the leader of the Bharatiya Janata Party. So there's no harm in kind of stating the leadership qualities of these two great leaders. Now, the point is, we are talking about the National Herald case. There has been certain misappropriation of funds. Let's stick to contest. I think we get overexcited and we try to cover everything under the sun except the issue that is being discussed today. We are discussing the National Herald case. We are discussing about the merits and demerits of this case. So let's stick to this. There has been a violation of the income tax rules. There has been a violation as far as providing funds to run the National Herald. This is the issue in hand. So let's discuss this. Let us stick to the issue. And comparison, yes, today the point is in politics. Obviously, there would be comparison. Even if there is no comparison, people compare. It is not the Bharatiya Janata Party that wants to compare. I think Rahul Gandhi has a long way to go. He is now being groomed as a leader in our nation. We welcome that. We want opposition. We want a strong opposition. We are not here to eliminate opposition. Certainly, opposition should be there.
Actually, is part of the story here. I'll ask
Are you kidding?
Mr. Desai, just 1 minute. Dr. Singhvi wants to come in. Go ahead, Mr. Singhvi.
Nidhi, excuse me.
Mr. Desai, I'll come back to you. Dr. Singhvi's had his hand up. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah. Number one, Mr. Bose, of course, has a very illustrious heritage and lineage. But I fear his bias to a particular party is allowing him to overwhelm the facts and truth. First obvious point, this is not a case even alleged by the government of India of misappropriation, defalcation and embezzlement. Three very purple words he used. Do you think Mr. Modi would wait 1 second before he foisted a Prevention of Corruption Act, CBI, NIA and some other agencies against Rahul Gandhi and Sonia Gandhi? That's not even the allegation. So let's not use words in confusion. Number two, the issue is very simple. Over 50 years, loans accrued from Congress Party to AJL on the books of AJL of 90 crores, they were simply converted into equity. Conversion of loans into equity is done by everyone because you have to clean up the balance sheet. The way it was converted into equity was to have a not-for-profit company, which can neither take out the shareholding, nor give dividends, nor pay remuneration, nor give salary. From 2004 or 5, when Mr. Swamy has been shouting about this, to 2014, from 2014 to 31st March 2018 at 11:38 p.m., the IT department did not think of reopening. Remember, this is a reopening case. It is reopening the assessment ending on 31/3/2012. Is that not vendetta? Is that not a context being created before elections?
Absolutely.
Is that not a fear, whether it is a fear of petrol and diesel prices or people, 21 parties coming together, or the kind of janakrosh and anger we see on the streets about Mr. Modi's government's mishandling of prices of rupee,
Mr. Bose, you want to answer about the timeline specifically? Why,
you,
when the complaint was filed so many years ago, why it wasn't taken up then? Let Mr. Bose answer that.
To the assessment of Mr. Gandhi.
Okay. Why did it happen just before midnight?
The income tax department is not run by Mr. Narendra Modi. He is the prime minister of our country. The income tax department follows certain procedures. We are in government today, but it is not that we give instructions to the income tax department. I don't think that's the way any government should function.
Should.
Right. So now,
should being the key word.
The issue is, if the income tax has raised certain queries, I think it is time we answer them. And the law courts would decide if there has not been any anomalies. If there has not been broken of any of the income tax rules, it would be dismissed. The case would be dismissed.
Yeah,
but why this impatience to establish that you are not corrupt?
But Mr. Bose has said he's
actually hit the nail on the head. But the BJP has been quick to say they are corrupt.
Exactly. Let the income tax department decide. So let them decide. Why is the BJP rushing forward with a press conference where they are already declaring Rahul Gandhi guilty when the investigation is yet to be started or yet to be completed?
Alleged. I think he is alleged. Okay, let me correct this. I don't think anybody has said that conclusively that he is guilty.
Are you feeling like cabinet minister?
Our friend Mr. Sambit Patra has said it as conclusively as he can. But interesting days ahead, because we're heading into election season now. We're actually full throttle into it. So I think we can expect a lot of fireworks on this front and on various other FIRs and cases. Many will have merit in them, many will not. Let's see how it goes. Thank you to all of you for joining us on Left, Right and Center tonight. We'll see you again tomorrow night. Goodbye.